Hey guys, this is Mr. Fortier, and I'm going to show you how to make a mug. We're going to start by pulling this cylinder shape out here, and we're going to get on that. Now, I want to show you something. If you click on any one of these corners, you will be able to change the shape of that cylinder. Now, you can drag it, make it long, you can make it skinny, you can click up here, make it tall. All that can happen. And the tendency is, if we try and make it larger, if we don't drag it just right, if we kind of get it off ever so slightly, it tends to change the shape, and we don't necessarily want to do that. Now, the good news is if you make that mistake, you can easily go up here and click on this little arrow button, or you can do Control Z, and it'll take you back to the original shape, or if you've changed it multiple times, you can go back as far as you need to until you get back to the original shape that you wanted. Now, if you want to keep it from losing its basic dimensional shapes, I mean, it will change in size, but you want it to basically be the same shape, the same cylindrical shape, not skinnier or wider than it really was, originally was. Then what you can do is you can come over here, put your cursor directly over this square, press shift on the keypad, and then as you depress your left click and then you drag it, it will maintain its basic symmetry. And it will get larger, but it won't lose its shape. It will keep the basic shape. I'm going to go 88 by 88, and you'll notice that all of these are actually 88 by 88. So it's 88 by 88 in length and width, and then height is also 88 millimeters. Now, I don't want it to be the same height as it is width and length, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this shape, I'm going to drag it back here to the middle, but I'm going to make it taller. I'm going to go up to about 101 millimeters. That's what I want right there. Now, there are two ways you could have done that. I could have just gone here, and if I want or don't want to risk, let's say I drug it too far. You can always just click on it, and you can write literally what you want in, and it'll go to that as well. So that's another way to eliminate any kind of potential errors if you know exactly how tall you want to make it, or how wide you want to make it, or how long you want to make it, depending on what you're doing. Okay, so we have our cylinder. Now, this is two dimension. So, according to this, it's 88 by 88 millimeters. That is approximately about, roughly around 3 inches. So it's 3 by 3, and then 101 millimeters is close to about 4 inches. So 3 by 3 and 4 inches high. That's about the size of our normal, regular coffee mug, especially, well, a pretty good size coffee mug at least. Okay, so you can manipulate this also, by the way, by clicking on your right click on your mouse and holding it down, and you can manipulate this in TinkerCad. If you don't have that option, you can always go up here, bring your cursor over here to this cube in the top left-hand corner, and you can manipulate it that way by moving it around. For right now, let's just stick with this. Okay, so I want to create a text and place it onto my mug as kind of like an engraving. So how am I going to do that? Well, first of all, I'm going to go over here to my menu, and there is a text section. It says text. Bring that out. All right, now I'm going to take this. Now, one of the issues I have now is it's kind of lying flat on this plane. Now, there's some different ways that you can handle this. You can go Shift W, and you can sometimes, or I think Control W, I'm sorry, and you can move it up and down on the plane, or you can just take this and we can rotate it. I think it's easier just to rotate it. Go over here. Now, we know we want to rotate it about 90 degrees, make it totally vertical up and down. So I'm going to do that. All right, and then I'm going to need to bring it up. Now, this little cone shape right here, this is what allows you to elevate the entire object or whatever you are trying to manipulate. It actually just picks it up and elevates it to a higher plane without stretching it. Now, if you want to stretch it and make it taller, you'd use the cubes or the squares here. Now, one of the issues I have is I think this text is too big, so I'm going to shrink it down a bit, make it about like that. Now, there's a couple of cool things I can do with this text. If I don't want it to say text, I can go up here to where it says shape, click on the drop down menu, and I can do different things. I can do different kinds of fonts. That's multilingual. You can do sans. Okay, you can do sans mono. And you can do serif. Okay, so not a whole lot of difference between these, but you can choose whichever one you like. I'm gonna go sans. All right, now, I don't want it to say text. I want it to say something different. Since this is a coffee mug that I'm making, I'm gonna make it into say coffee. There we go. That's what I want it to say. Now, the next issue you might have is the alignment. Now, I can you can either if you know exactly where it needs to be in alignment with the mug, you can type in that, or you can adjust it, play with it. The problem is you often don't quite get it exactly right, and you'll find that because this is a 3D rendering, you might be off in a certain one of the plane ratios. So TinkerCAD has made it easier for you to align it without having to worry about whether you're doing it correctly manually. So if you'll take your square, drag it across the whole picture like that, now you can align it. Now you have these openings that just came up in the menus. You can go grouping things. You can do it two different ways. You can group it by just clicking on this icon, or you can go Control G. Over here, we can go to alignment simply by clicking L. So if I have grouped these together and I click L on my keypad, it then gives me these tabs. So once you get more efficient, you can, and you remember these keys, you can just use these keys real quick, and you don't have to go around moving your cursor all over the TinkerCAD board. So the first thing we'll do is we'll align it from left to right by clicking in this tab right here. Now, if I wanted to come all the way over here, I could do that. If I wanted to come all the way over here, I could do that. But I want it to be dead in the middle, so I'm going to do there. Now we want to align it from top to bottom to make sure it's in perfect alignment from the top to the bottom of the mug. Do that. Now we know that our writing is in alignment. Now I just now noticed something. I didn't notice this before when I typed it, but I've accidentally made a capital C and a capital O. I'm going to go correct that real quick by my... Oh, you got to click out of it. Just click on only the text. If you're having a hard time and it's making you click on the wrong thing, you can just angle it so that you can get only the text. So I'm going to correct that real quick, and I see where my mistake was. Correcting that, now it is fixed. Okay, so now that I've got my coffee word correct, I'm going to show you how to engrave it on here. So the first thing you want to do is you want to look here. You'll see these squares, and whichever square you are about to click that you will be affecting will turn red. We're going to left click on this square. We're going to drag this word all the way through. Okay, and that's what we want to do. We want to make sure that it's going all the way through our object, just like so. Now you notice this is the mirror image of what you want to write. So I'm going to show you that we're not going to worry about this back side as much. We're going to say this is the front side. This is the part that's the important part. Okay, now, how am I going to get this onto that cylinder? I'm going to use a square to do this. So I'm going to pull this square out here. Okay. All right, now we're going to bring it up here. And I'm going to stretch it back. Sorry, I hit the wrong one. I'm going to stretch it back behind there. And then I'm going to drag it across here. And I want to make sure that I've covered up all of the cylinder at the base, and I'm making it past all of the writing in the back, but I want to leave the writing in the front, the text in the front, not fully covered. So I'm going to raise this rectangle up so you see that it's covering up the entire text, but I'm not covering up the front of the text. I want this projecting outward. That's important. I'll show you why in a second. But I do want to cover up this whole backside because we don't want the reversed image of coffee written on the back of our mug. We're not going to use that, and I'll show you how we're going to deal with that. Okay, so now that I've done this, okay, what I'm now going to do is I'm going to make a duplication of this cylinder right here. So I make this cylinder, I've clicked on the cylinder, and I'm going to duplicate this. So what this does is, and you can do it two different ways. You can go Control D. Now I've duplicated the cylinder. And as you can see, if I drag down, you'll see there's a line. So that means there are two cylinders now that are superimposed upon each other. They're not the same cylinder, and they're different. Okay, so this is the duplicated cylinder that we're affecting at this very moment. Okay, now, I'm going to take that duplicated cylinder, and I'm going to drag it down so that's even with the rectangle. Okay? I'm also going to, now, I'm going to take this coffee, and I'm going to change the shape. Actually, we're not on the coffee, so let me turn it so I make sure that we're clicked on the coffee only. So we are going to do something with this shape. We're going to make it into a negative space instead of a positive space. So I click here, and I can make it hollow. Now, you can either do that, or you can just press H. Now I've made it hollow. Now that it's hollow, this is going to push all the way through into the rectangle and through the cylinder, specifically the duplicated cylinder that I just put in there. Now I want to join this coffee symbol and I want to group it with this rectangle. How do I do that without accidentally clicking on the cylinder? So I can press shift and then click onto the rectangle. Now that I've done that, I can group them together by going, remember it's Control G. So I can go Control G. Now I've grouped them together and now there's a hole in this rectangle that's shaped like the word coffee. Now that I've done that, I'm going to do something else. Now I'm going to take the rectangle and I'm going to turn the rectangle into a hole, just like so. All right, see how that's happened? Now this is important that you recognize what we're doing here. So now I'm going to take that rectangle and I'm going to group it with the, remember how we had the, actually let's do this. So I can actually change the shape of the coffee as well, but I'm gonna pull this down so I can make sure that I'm clicking on the correct cylinder. That's the incorrect cylinder. I'm gonna make that go back up to 101. Or I can just do this, 1, all right. And there's a duplicated cylinder down here that I think has been grouped with the rectangle. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to bring the rectangle back up. Oops, we're going to undo that. We're going to do this, do this, do this. All right, now we're back where we should be. Okay, so now that I've done this, I can group all this together. Okay, so I got to... yeah, group all this together. All right, so you see what has happened? I lost everything that was right there. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to go back and I'm going to do something different. Now, this time I'm going to duplicate the cylinder again. Go back and duplicate the cylinder. Once again, I'm going to drag this part down. I'm going to leave that that way. And then I'm going to connect it to this rectangle. Now I'm going to group them. And see what has happened. Okay, now I can actually move this cylinder out. And we now have that. Okay, so you can see what I've done there. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of this one. I'm going to raise this one to the original height that I had it. We're going to make this 101. Okay, and then we're going to make sure that these are still 88, and they are. Okay, so now we have our engraving on our coffee mug. See how that's worked? Now it's kind of projecting out. And here's the thing. Now I can manipulate this. I can pull it out. I can recess it in. I can do this. I'm going to let it be kind of sticking out like so, because that's what I want. I want it to kind of stick out and make that work. Now, if I wanted to, I could come in and make this into another hole. And then it would actually cause it to be recessed in, or it would be a hole, the hole unfortunately would run throughout the entirety of the coffee mug. We don't want that. Let's go ahead and make sure there's nothing poking out on the back. So we've got our coffee written right here. So now you have your engraving on your coffee mug. Next step. It's really not good to have a coffee mug that doesn't have a handle. So let's go make our handle. I'm going to use this Taurus right here, and this is probably the best one for a handle. Now we're going to go ahead and make it go vertical. So we're going to click on this, we're going to make this 90 degrees. Sorry, that's not what I intended to do, but I can fix that. Go back to where we were. Okay, so I hit the wrong button, is what happened. I hit the vertical, the actual cone. Makes it go up in the air. Now I'm going to go 90 degrees. This is turning it. Now you see that it's turned on its side. That's what we wanted. Okay, now I can bring it upward, and now I can even control its height and width. Okay, so I'm going to control how tall I want it. So it's at about 20 millimeters right now. We know that the whole height of this cup is right at 101 millimeters. So let's go about 60 millimeters in height. Let's make this 60 millimeters tall. So I'm going to click on this. I'm going to go 60 and see what that does. That's a pretty good ratio. Now, I'm going to make this a little bit thicker. So I'm going to make it about... So right now it's 5 millimeters. Let's make it 10. All right, that's a little bit thicker. That's a good handle to be able to grab onto. All right, and so it's going to be, we don't want it a full inch or anything like that. So I think we could even make this a little bit taller. So we already have it set at 60. So let's go ahead and go to 70. I don't think we want to go to a full 80. Let's go 70. All right, that looks like a good height. All right, now. And I'm going to make it wider. So that's 10 right here. So let's make this about 30. There we go. Whoops. Let's undo that one. That didn't do the right thing. This is what I meant to click on. Let's make this 40, actually. There we go. That's what I wanted. Okay, so now that we have done that, once again comes in the question of alignment. Well, we can do that very easily. Just drag your cursor over the tube while you're making your box. That's doing right, what we call right click. I'm sorry, left click. Drag that over the tube. We're gonna now align them. I'm gonna press L to align it. And I'm gonna, first of all, I don't wanna align it here because that's gonna push this into the mug more than I want it. I wanna align it here first. Okay, now I wanna align it here. Now it's in the center of the mug and it's at the right height. Now what I can easily do now at this point is I can unclick on that. Now I can click on the handle and I can just kind of maneuver the handle into the mug. Now I might want this not quite that far in, so pull it out a little bit more. Now I've got a good handle. All right, now if I don't feel like the alignment is just right, once again, let's check the alignment. I'm going to realign this. Now it's in the middle and it's basically where I want it to be. So I'm not going to do any more with the actual mug itself. Now I've noticed that my coffee symbol, something has changed with it. Let's see if I can't click directly on that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sure, I think with my alignment somehow it affected the coffee symbol. So we haven't joined anything and made anything permanent yet, so we can still pull that coffee symbol out just a bit. There we go. Now, I'm also going to make sure this part is not showing, so I'm pushing it in. Now the coffee is still sticking out. That backside looks good. Now, in order to keep this from shifting and changing anymore, we're going to group all these together. Once again, do that, and then we're gonna go Control G. That groups them together, so now this is one solid piece. All right, now, one thing we're missing is that it's a solid piece. It doesn't have an empty middle, which is what you need to make it into a cup or a mug. So we're going to make that hollow section right now. Now, some of you might think, oh, I'm going to grab this tube and just stick it in there and then make it hollow. No, that doesn't work because it won't hollow out the middle because the tube has nothing in the middle. So what we need to do is, there's a couple of different ways you can do this, depending on how you want to shape it and how you want to do this. Now, I am going to make, you can do a flat shape by simply making the bottom of this completely flat, allows a little bit more coffee in there. So all you'd have to do that would be to choose another cylinder, fill it in, make it into a negative space, and then join them together, and then you have your hole. Or if you do like some people do, you can do use one of these guys, like this shape right here. Now, of course, the first thing you have to do, if you're going to use this shape and have a curved bottom, is you need to flip it over. So if you do a complete half turn, that's 180 degrees. So we're going to flip it 180 degrees. Now it's up on its end. Now what we're going to do is we're going to rise it up, and we're going to have to center it directly over the middle. So let's go ahead and align it. Okay, so the first thing, let's go ahead and align it. The first thing I want to do is align it here. So now they're aligned here. Next thing I want to do is align it here. Okay, now, it doesn't seem to be totally centered, does it? And the reason for that is because it's so small, it's kind of impossible to totally center it. So what we're going to do now is we're going to make this one larger. Okay, so, actually, let me try this. I haven't thought about that. Line. Now I'm going to click directly on here. And you can see that it's already aligned for most of this. So, okay, so what we're going to do right now is I'm going to make this larger. Once again, I'll click on Shift so that I don't change its actual shape. I'll just make it larger. Now I can move this into the middle and gradually make it larger and move this into the middle. Okay, now as we do this, we're going to make it a little bit larger. And so you can see, you want to be able to, if you look straight down on it, and now what we're going to do is we're going to align it again. Align it to the middle here. And part of the problem is it's also going to align this handle in. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click off of this and I'm going to align this a little bit more here. Now I think it's a little bit too big, so now that I know what I'm clicking on, I'm going to shift, make it a little bit smaller, and you can kind of get a general idea of how big it needs to be. So now I've got it pretty much centered. If you want to do it in alignment again, you can, but I know it's going to be slightly off because I now have the handle in there. So if you wanted to make it perfectly in the middle of the cylindrical portion of the mug, you can't use the align tool right now unless you did not already attach the handle. But I attached the handle for a very specific reason already, because if I'm going to hollow this out, I also know that part of this handle is projecting inward into the solid space. So if I hollow out all the part of the middle, that is also going to ensure that the handle will, that portion of the handle will also be hollowed out, and we won't have to worry about that. So you can just kind of take this angle and see how I'm making it very good, very close to the center. As close to the center as you can get, and it might have a slight thickness on one side or another, but I think that's pretty good. Okay, now how do I handle this from this point? Now I'm gonna click on this, and now what we're going to do, we're gonna have to back away, is we're going to drag this downward. Actually, what we want to do is this, but we need to, okay, we're going to just make it taller. Let's make it taller. Okay, about like that. And then we're going to bring the whole thing, well, let's bring it back to where it was. Okay, now I'm going to make sure that you get the cone part. Now we're going to push it down into the cup. We can still make it taller, and it doesn't matter if it's a lot taller than the cup. Now you can see right here, you can see where the base is, so you can push it down till it's not quite to the bottom, but near to the bottom. Okay, that's what we want right there. And what this is going to do now, and now if I want to, I can still widen this out a bit by pressing Shift and just ever so slightly enlarging it, and then we're going to adjust it here. Okay, so now that was my alarm going off. We now have this where we want it. So I'm going to bring it down about, let me see if we can't make sure that it's all aligned correctly. I think it needs to be adjusted just ever so slightly here. Okay. Make it a little bit bigger. And then we're going to adjust it over here. Alright, so you shouldn't be able to really see, when you're looking straight down, you shouldn't see the edges of the mug. but you can see that it's pretty much even all the way across. Okay, now what am I going to do? All right, so we know it's not all the way on the bottom, it's down right here, so we're good there. So now we're going to make this into an empty space. We're going to hole it out, and now we can actually see what it's going to look like from the top. And you see that it's pretty much even all the way around. Now we can group these two together. Group those two together. And now they're one. And you have now made a coffee mug. Let's take a closer look at it. You got your coffee right here, so it meets that criteria. It's got a handle on it. It seems to be somewhat unique. You have a space for your drink to fit. And you now have a hollowed out coffee mug. I hope this is helpful to you guys, and look forward to seeing your projects in the future. And I'll talk to you guys.